The community of Ohangwena region and the national leaders flocked to the Ohalosu Church to pay their last respect to their fallen leader. Ninda has been a councillor of Endora constituency since 2004 and a member of parliament in the National Council. She was a teacher by profession and joined Swapo Party in 1988, and it was in that same year she was elected the Swapo branch coordinator for Ohalosu in the Ohangwena region. Speaker after speaker described Ninda as a hard-working woman who was full of energy in the fight against social injustice. The Swapo Party Secretary General Nangolo Mbumba, in his message of condolences, described Ninda's departure as a big loss to the nation as she was a mentor and a unifier. His message was delivered by the Works and Transport Minister Elkinyim Tina.
The Swapo Party did not only lose a dedicated, committed, disciplined, and hard-working politician, the country lost a teacher. Corporate Ninda played several roles in different leadership positions, from being a branch coordinator to the membership of the regional council and the regional executive committee and national council.
Ninda served in various standing committees in the national council and was passionate about the promotion of gender equality and rural development. National Council Chairperson Asel Kapere described her as a visionary, strong leader who had the nation at heart.
Therefore, in order to honor the legacy of Honorable Comrade Ruth Ninda, I make today a deliberate appeal to all men, particularly those who indulge themselves in domestic violence in the form of beating, rape, incest, and the murdering of mothers, sisters, and daughters, to take it from me as advice and instruction to stop immediately and unconditionally with such barbaric acts.
Ninda is survived by her husband, Matthew Ninda, and 8 children. On Friday, the region also buried former regional councillor for Oshikango constituency, Hiaverwa Nambinga, who was killed in a horrific car accident. 71-year-old Hiaverwa Nambinga was buried at his home village, Okadiva. For NBC News, Pandurani Nepembe at Ohalosu.